Welcome, all my dear students of TYBC Physics class. Today we are going to start the last chapter, sequential logic circuits of this electronic paper. Okay. The two basic devices most widely used in digital electronics or in digital circuits are logic gates and flip flops, and this is already studied by you at SIBC level. And I say there are two basic devices which are mostly or which are widely used in digital electronic circuit, and that are nothing but logic gates and flip flop. What is flip flop? Flip flops are basically bistable multivibrator. Don't forget it. Flip flops are basically bistable multivibrator. In any ordinary circuit, the output will depend on input to the circuit. Okay, what I say? In any ordinary circuit, the output will depend on input to the circuit. But if a feedback is given from output to input, obviously the output will depend on input as well as the previous output state. Such a circuit acquires capacity to store one bit of information. A flip-flop is a circuit, digital circuit, that has two outputs, Q and Q bar. Q and Q bar. If Q is equal to 1, then Q bar is 0. And when Q bar is, when Q is equal to 0, then Q bar is equal to 1. We can say that, from this we can say that Q bar is the complementary output of Q, or Q bar is the complement of Q. If Q is equal to 0, Q bar is equal to 1, or when Q is equal to 1, Q bar is equal to 0. So Q bar is the complementary output to the output Q. So here I told you that a flip-flop is a digital circuit that has two output state, Q and Q bar, which are always in opposite state. If Q is 0, then Q bar is equal to 1, and if Q is equal to 1, then Q bar is equal to 0. Okay. And remember that if Q bar is equal to 1, then Q bar is equal to 0 and flip-flop is said to be set. Now if Q is equal to 0 and Q bar is equal to 1, then flip-flop is said to be reset. So from this set reset, the name arises SR flip-flop or reset set, that is RS flip-flop. There are several types of flip-flops. A digital circuit designed by using flip-flop and having a memory is called sequential logic circuit. So this is very important point. For example, point of view, question may be asked like this: what is a sequential logic circuit? Or question may be of multiple choice question type, or question may be of true and false type. So you should have to remember forever that what is digital circuit. The answer is very simple. What is sequential circuit? So answer is very simple. A digital circuit designed by using flip-flop having a memory is called a sequential logic circuit. Okay. Now in number of flip-flop put together constitute a register which can store a multiple data, and in addition to the storage data, it is also used in counting and generating and processing of waveform. But registers and counters are now out of the syllabus. From this, we are going to study only flip-flops, different type of flip-flops. So we are going to start now from flip-flop. What is flip-flop? And what will be the answer for this question? So make your concentration here. A flip-flop is a bistable device. Bi means two. Stable state. A flip-flop is a bistable device. That means it is having two outputs. It has two stable states. One of them is 1 and another is 0. Flip-flop are also known as a latch. In digital electronics, latch means a lock. Flip-flop is also known as, or flip-flops are also known as latches. A flip-flop will remain in one stable state in which it has been put. What I say, remember that and keep this in your mind forever. A flip-flop will remain one stable state in which it has been put until it is triggered into other state. The flip-flop can be built with NAND gate or NOR gate. The flip-flops can be built with NAND gate or NOR gate. First of all, we are going to see the flip-flop built with NAND gate. So first of all, we are going to see RS flip-flop. This is the circuit which is built up by using two NAND gates. This is first NAND gate and this is second NAND gate. AND gate, there are two types of logic gates. First one, basic logic gates, OR and NOT, and hybrid logic gate, NAND, NOR and XOR. And these all gates are studied by you at ESIBSC, so it is not necessary to explain them again. Okay. The RS flip-flop is most basic flip-flop. RS flip-flop. First of all, here we are going to see RS flip-flop. And this is the most basic flip-flop. And all other flip-flops are obtained from this RS flip-flop. This RA flip-flop has two inputs, reset and set, or set and reset. RS flip-flop has two inputs. S mean set and R mean reset, and two outputs, Q and Q bar. I already told that Q bar is the complementary or complement of this Q. Okay. When flip-flop is set, make your concentration, when the flip-flop is set, it is said to be to store a binary bit 1. What I say, the state of flip-flop can be ascertained before that, when flip-flop is set. That means what? It is said to be store a binary 1 bit or binary 1. And when it has been reset, that means obviously it stores a binary 0. The state of the flip-flop can be ascertained, in Marathi khatri karun ghene, the state of the flip-flop can be ascertained by looking the output Q. If Q is equal to 1, then flip-flop is set, and if Q is equal to 0, then flip-flop is reset. A RS flip-flop, that is reset set flip-flop, can be wired or can be constructed by using NAND gate as well as NOR gate. So first here we are going to study the RS flip-flop using NAND gate. So here this figure illustrates RS flip-flop using NAND gate. There are two NAND gate, this one and this one. This RS flip-flop can be constructed in this way. That means the RS flip-flop can be constructed by using two NAND gate in a such a way that output of first NAND gate will be served as the input of second NAND gate and vice versa. Okay, this is very simple construction. Now we are going to see the working of this RS flip-flop using NAND gate, and then from this working we are going to check the truth table of this RS flip-flop by using NAND gate. So there are four cases, 1, 2, 3, and 4. First of all, we are going to see first case. In first case, when both the inputs are high, logically high, that is 1 and 1, if S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 1, the output will not change. Remember that output will not change, and the flip-flop will either set or reset as shown in this figure. So here suppose S is equal to 1, whatever may be the another input, suppose this is also 1, then 1 into 1, output of NAND gate is 0. So complementary is 0, and this 0 is given here. If this is again 1, 1 into 0, 0, and 0 into 1. Okay, so suppose here, suppose this is 1 and this is 1, S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 1. Okay, and now suppose here 0, when 1 is here, obviously output will be 0, and this 0 is coming here, and 0 into 1, 0, and output of AND gate is 0, and output of NAND gate is complementary, that is 1. So here is 1. Okay, here is 0. Okay, and this 1 is coming here, 1 into 1, see here, 1 into 1, 1 into 1, 0, 0 comes here, 0 into 1, 1. In this case, consider previous state as 1. Suppose this is previous state, this one is previous state, consider previous state, output is 1. Obviously when one is Q is equal to 1, then it's complementary or it complete is 0, complementary output is 0. Then this 0, what you see, when in the first case consider previous output state Q is equal to 1, and this Q is equal to 1 come here, 1 into 1, 0. Okay, then the input to upper state is 1 and 0, making the output 1, and this input 1 to lower gate will be here again 1 and 1, 0. Thus output state will not be changed, and similarly the previous output state is, if suppose this is 0, then 0 here, 0 into 1, 0, and then 1, 0 into, suppose this is 0, 0 into 1, this second state, if this is 0, and when this 0 is applied, I come here 0 or applied here, 0 into 1, then 1, and this one is again here 1 into 1, 0. Here also the output will not change, and this is shown in this truth table. when 1, both are 1, then no change or same output as the previous state. And this is denoted by Qn, and its complex, its complements is Qn bar. Okay. Now we are going to see the second case. Suppose this is first case, this is second case. Now in this second case, when S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 1, or when R is equal to 1 and S is equal to 0, when S is equal to 0, when S is equal to 0, then obviously Q bar is equal to 1, and when Q bar is equal to 1, this one comes here, okay, and R is equal to 1, 1 into 1, 0, output is 0, okay. Then here I am again going to tell you, when R is equal to 1 and S is equal to 0, when S is equal to 0, then this complement output is 1, and when this 1 is provided here, here is 1, 1 into 1, 0, again this 0 comes here, and 0 into 0, 1. That means when S is equal to 0, it means that one of the input of lower gate is 0, which makes the complementary output, that is QR, is equal to 1, here 1. And now inputs to the upper gate is 1 and 1, and which makes Q is equal to 0. And when Q is equal to, which makes, now inputs to upper gates is 1 and 1, which makes Q is equal to 0. When Q is equal to 0, the flip-flop is a reset. The flip-flop is reset, this one state. Okay. Thus, for S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 1, irrespective of any previous output state, Q is equal to 0 and Q bar is equal to 1. Okay. Now we are going to see the next case, that is third case. In this third case, we exchange the value of S and R. Now S is equal to 1. Now S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 0. Okay. Then R is equal to 0, case third. When R is equal to 0, it means that one of the inputs of, one of the inputs to upper gate is 0, which makes the Q bar is equal to, Q is equal to 1. When R is equal to 0, it means that one of the inputs to upper gate is 0, which makes Q is equal to 1. And now this 1 is provided here. So for lower NAND gate, 1 and 1 are the inputs. Okay. This means that when 1 and 1, Q bar is equal to 0. This, flip-flop is set. Okay. Thus, for S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 0, see here, flip-flop is set. Thus, for S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 0, irrespective of any output, Q is equal to 1 and Q complements is 0, and flip-flop is said to be set. For, remember that, when Q is equal to 1, flip-flop is set, and when R is equal to 1, complement is equal to 1, then flip-flop is reset. In this way, third condition is verified, and in this case flip-flop is set. Now next condition, last, when both are 0, when S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 0, this is the most complicated state, and hence it is avoided. See here, when S is equal to 0, then s is equal to 0, then complementary output is 1. Okay. Then s is equal to s will 0, qn is equal to, and when r1 is equal to, sorry, when r is equal to 0, then q is equal to rc 0. But it is meaningless, because when q is equal to 0, q is equal to 0, its complements, sorry, its complementary output must be opposite. Then q is equal to 1, q bar must be 0, and when q is equal to 0, then q bar must be 1. And here this is the not case. When both are 0, q is equal to 1 and q bar is also 1. This is absurd, meaningless. So this condition is not useful. Okay, hence combination is equal to, so combination s is equal to 0 and r is equal to 0 is not allowed, and the action of flip-flop is like this. So this table summarizes the four cases. Okay. I am again going to, when both inputs are same, high, logically high, then there will be no change in output. When s is equal to 0 and r is equal to 1, then q is equal to 0 and q bar is equal to 1 and flip flop is reset. And when s is equal to 1 and q bar is equal to 0, then our q is equal to 1 and q bar is equal to 0 and flip flop is set. And when both are 0, then output are meaningless, outputs are meaningless, and this is invalid. Okay. Now we are going to see the construction of second RS flip flop by using NOR gate, by using NOR gate, and this is the case. Suppose this is the first case, by using NAND gate, and this is by using NOR gate. There are two NOR gate, this one and this one. Remember that the RS flip-flop can be designed by using NOR gate as shown in this figure, and there are basic difference, there are basic difference in the operation of RS flip-flop using NOR gate and, sorry, NOR gates than using NAND gates. What I say, there are some basic difference, or sorry, there are some basic differences in operation of RS flip-flop using NOR gates than using NAND gates. In this case, a position of normal output Q and its complement has been reversed. Okay, so here instead of R, we take S. This is RS, this is SR. This is Q, Q bar here, Q bar, and we just reverse it. And then action of this flip-flop can be like this. See here, what will be the first case? In first case, when reverse, we are going to reverse the explanation of this. So when both inputs are 0, r is equal to 0, sorry, s is equal to 0 and r is equal to 0. When both are 0, then output will maintain its previous state. That's when there is no change in output. Whereas here, when both the inputs are, when IS and R, when R and R and S is equal to 1, then output will remains the same, or output will not change. And here reverse, when in NAND gate, by using NAND gate, when R and S is equal to 1, at that time output will not change, it will remains the same as that of previous case. Here when both S and R is equal to 0, then output will maintain its previous state, that means output will not change. Okay, so then see here, when both the inputs are low, this one and this one, and now when this is 0, and suppose this is 0. When both the inputs of NOR gate is 0, obviously it outputs is 1. And flip-flop will set. When this 1 is provided here, 1 into 0, output is 0. Output is 0. Okay. And controversy, when here, when 1 is applied here instead of 0, here 1, then obviously 1 plus 0 and its complex conjugate is 0. And when this 0 is applied here, 0 into 0, 0 plus 0, 0 and its complex conjugate is 1. This is the second case. So, see here, if the previous output state is 1, Q is equal to 1 and Q bar is equal to 0, this 0, then the output will be same and flip-flop will set. And Q is equal to 0, flip-flop will set. See here, set. Okay. Now, similarly, the flip-flop will reset for previous value Q is equal to 0. Suppose this is 0. When this is 0, this 0 provides here 0 plus 0, 0 and its complex conjugate is 1. At that time, flip-flop is analyzed like this. Now, in second case, this is the case first. Now we are going to second case. Don't be confused. Okay. Now in second case, when S is equal to 1, S is equal to 1. In second case, when S is equal to 1, instead of first here we consider, when S is equal to 1, and R is equal to, S is equal to 1, R is equal to 0, then the output of upper gate, see here, 1, S is equal to, what I say, 1, and R is equal to 0, this is the case, then output of upper gate, 1, whatever will be the second gate, but this will be, suppose 1, I mean 0. Output 1 plus 0, G1, 1 and its complement is 0. So, this is 0, Q bar. And when this 0 is provided here, 0 plus 0, 0 and its its complement is 1. Okay, so here inputs to lower gate is 0, 0, which makes Q is equal to high, that is logically 1, and the input to upper gate is 1 and 1, S is already 1. Which makes Q bar is equal to 0 and therefore flip-flop is set. Here flip-flop is set. And third condition, if S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 1, S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 1, that is this condition. We just checking the truth table. Here, when S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 1, then output of lower gates is 0. When S is equal to 0, okay, and R is equal to 1, then output of lower gate is 0. Since R is equal to 1. Now, the inputs to upper gate. Then this is 0 is coming here, 0. Inputs of upper gate is 0, 0. So output is 1. Output will be 1. And when this 1 is applied here, 1 into 1, 0. Here we can say that the inputs to upper gate are 0, 0. This will make the complementary output 1. And this output 1 is fed to lower gate. So here 1 into 1, the inputs inputs for lower gate is 1 and 1, giving Q is equal to 0. This means that the flip-flop is reset. Okay. When S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 1, flip-flop is reset. And last case, when S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 1, when S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 1, then what happen? The S1, S is equal to 1, will force Q bar into 0. And then this R is equal to, sorry, and when R is equal to 1, will force Q to 0 and both 0. Q is equal to 0 and complement, its complement is 0. This is absurd. This is meaningless. Hence, this is avoided. And in this way, we can study both RS flip-flop using NAND gate and RS flip-flop by using this. Okay. So, this is the only case, only here reverse. This is here, when both are 0, output is remains same. That is no change. And when both are 1, then output is invalid. This is the main difference. Okay. In next lecture, we will study the next flip-flop, that is clocked RS flip-flop. And this clocked RS flip-flop is derived from clocked RS flip-flop by using NAND gate, clocked RS flip-flop by using NAND gate. And this clocked RS flip-flop is obtained from this flip-flop. Okay. So, we shall stop here. Have a good day.